dear students. So today we deal with the chapter that is solution. So in your last class you have already learned the concept of colligative property. So what is mean by colligative property? So that is a property where it mainly it goes with the number of, in the sense, solute particle. It doesn't go with the nature of the particle. Mainly it goes with the number of the particle. Due to that reason, what will happen? Due to the presence of number of particle, the vapor pressure varies. Vapor pressure decreasing when takes place. You know, when your solvent is there, for that if you add any of the solute, so that it goes with the decreasing of vapor pressure. So the same thing it will happen with other kind of solution also. There are many reasons, and these are some of the factors which are explained last class regarding relative lowering of vapor pressure, elevation in boiling point, as well as depression in freezing point and osmotic pressure. So these are the some of the factors which mainly it goes with the number of solid particles, not on the nature. Okay, so there, I mean, because of this factor, in the sense, these factors directly it depends on the number of the particles, not on the nature. So in last class I have explained regarding this concept. So the relative lowering of vapor pressure, so mainly it goes with, in the sense, that is a relation between mole fraction of the solute. Okay, so the formula what we have that comes like P0 minus P divided by P0 is equal to x2. So this is your relative lowering of vapor pressure. Mainly it depends on the mole fraction of solute. So in a sense, second phase is nothing, second component is nothing, but always it is solute. So we, I mean, it depends on the mole fraction of the solute. Okay, so this you can expand by using of number of moles of the particle, because mole fraction is nothing but number of particle, I mean moles of the particle of a particular component divided by total number of moles of the particle. Okay, so where in your dilute solution you are going to consider, by that term you are going to neglect some of the concept. In the sense, when you go with the dilute solution, there concentration of solid particle will be very less, N2 will be very less, so that you will be neglecting in denominator, so that you will get N2 by N1, and you are going to substitute. What is mean by number of moles? Number of moles you can write in terms of mass by molar mass. So that mass by molar mass you are going to substitute, and you will get a formula so that it can be used to calculate the molar mass, can be calculated, as well as relative lowering of pressure also calculated by using of those formula. The next concept that we will be dealing, that is elevation in boiling point. So the second property or qualitative property, that is nothing but elevation in boiling point. So elevation in the sense, increase in boiling point will take place. So before going to the concept, we should know what is mean by boiling point. So boiling point is nothing but it is a constant temperature at which the vapor pressure of a liquid, it becomes equal to the vapor pressure of your atmosphere. For example, in a beaker you are taking water, you are going to give heat, temperature will be given, okay, heat will be given, so that it started boiling. So I mean, when we can say that the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius, because as it boils, by that time the vapor pressure whatever has been produced from the water, okay, so that vapor pressure, it will be equal to the atmospheric, I mean, vapor pressure. Generally we takes with 1 bar. So vapor pressure of your liquid, it is equal to the vapor pressure of your atmosphere. So that will be considered as boiling point. So boiling point is nothing but, this is a constant temperature at which the vapor pressure of liquid becomes equal to the vapor pressure of atmosphere. Okay, and when it becomes equal to the atmospheric vapor pressure, then we are going to call it as boiling point. So generally we know that for a pure solvent, if you take, okay, you have a pure solvent, you know what is the difference between solute and solvent. Solute is nothing but where the concentration of the particle will be less, and solvent is nothing but where the concentration of the particle, in the sense, mainly it goes with the medium, okay, so that will be more in amount. So now if you are taking pure solvent, okay, take a pure solvent and just take the vapor pressure, check the vapor pressure, and you just add the solute, okay, add a solute inside the atom, the vapor pressure of the solution now it will decrease. Okay, so vapor pressure of pure solvent will be more when you compare with the vapor pressure of the solution, right? So now here, if you go with the concept of your elevation in boiling, but the same thing it goes. In the sense, when you add solute to the solvent, in the sense pure solvent, vapor pressure decreases. Now, what we have to do to increase the vapor pressure? Just give temperature. So when the temperature will be given, vapor pressure will increases. When the temperature is given, in the sense by that time boiling point of the particular solution will go on increasing. So if you go with the graph for this particular concept, so the graph will come in this manner. Okay. So now graph really goes with vapor pressure versus your temperature. Okay, vapor pressure versus temperature, when the graph will be here. First we will take for the pure solvent. So when you will take pure solvent, as the temperature increases, vapor pressure will increase. So there it goes in this manner. See, okay, curve graph here you will get. This is only for pure solvent. Okay. Now consider, here you have a boiling point. Okay. So this liquid, whatever you have taken, pure solvent, it will get warming, it's boiling point over here. Okay. In this vapor pressure, it will get boiling point. So this boiling point we can consider as TB naught. Why it is TB naught? It is boiling point, elevation boiling point of pure solvent. So not wet, I mean that this naught, it represents, it goes with the pure solvent. Okay, so this is for pure solvent. Now, for this solid, you just add solid, I mean solute you get. Addition of solid, what will happen? The vapor pressure will decrease. Now the part, now solution, whatever the vapor pressure will show, so that it will be lesser than this. So it shows curve in this manner. Okay, but as the temperature increases, its vapor pressure also go on increasing. For solution, okay, for solution, by that time it also will have a freezing point. So I mean, sorry, boiling point. So consider this is the boiling point, okay. So boiling point in the sense, vapor pressure of the liquid becomes equal to the vapor pressure of the atmosphere, okay. So this you consider the boiling point of the solution, okay. So this will just be a test dP. This one we know it as TB, elevation in boiling point. Okay, with the temperature, varying with the temperature. So as vapor pressure increases, this is as the temperature increases, vapor pressure of the solution also increases. So that boiling point also will increases with the particular solution. So now whatever the difference is there between this, so that will be considered as elevation in boiling point. Whatever the difference between the boiling point of pure solvent as well as solution. Okay, it will be this, so that will be considered as elevation in boiling point. So that will be mentioned in terms of delta TB. So delta TB is nothing but elevation in boiling point. So as I said, so here what will happen for pure solvent, whatever the vapor pressure will be there, just add solute to it, by that time the vapor pressure of that solution increases. Now we have to give the temperature. Go on giving the temperature, by that time vapor pressure increases as well as the boiling point also. See, boiling point where it comes, with what temperature it comes. So boiling point also of the solution will increase. So whatever the difference will be there of boiling point of solution as well as pure solvent, so that will be considered as delta TB. So here whatever the difference or elevation boiling point that will get, mainly it depends on the number of the particle. So we can write what is mean by delta TB over here. So delta TB we can calculate, that is TB minus TB naught, in the sense the boiling point of solution minus boiling point of pure solvent. Okay. So if you look, you will get what is the difference between the boiling point. Okay. That is nothing but elevation in boiling point. You will get it this one. So delta TB is equal to TB minus TB naught. Okay. So now here what will happen regarding this concept. So your elevation in boiling point, generally it connected or it is related with your molality. Okay. So your delta TB is related with your molarity. How it is related? Those are directly proportional. Okay? So those are directly proportional. Why? Because it depends on the number of the particle, right? Okay? So number of the particle, generally we can vary in terms of molarity as well as molarity concept, right? So here we are going to take in terms of mass, so it is easy to go with the molarity. Okay? Small m. Okay? So this equation we can also write it as delta TB is equal to KB into m. Okay? So now what is mean by KB? This is nothing but constant. So that will be considered as, I'll just write over here, KB is nothing but molar elevation boiling point constant. Okay? Or boiling point constant. Boiling point elevation constant also we can call. Or it can also called as ebullioscopic constant. Ebullioscopic constant. So this KB, it varies with the different kinds of solution. Okay? KB, it varies with the different kinds of solution. So delta TB is equal to KB into M. Now what is mean by M? You can expand it. So delta TB is equal to KB. M is nothing but molarity formula. Generally it goes with mass by molar mass, right? Okay. So W 2. What is mean by molarity? Molarity, it goes with the number of particles or number of moles of solute divided by into 1000 W1. We can write in terms of A as well as B also, no problem. Okay. So how we have written in last time based on molarity, molarity. So based on that only A, B, A, B also you can mention in the puzzle. So whenever they ask range of the problem to find out the delta T, in a sense to find out elevation in boiling point, you can use this formula, or else to find M2. Okay, they will ask you to find out molar mass of solute. By that time, you can go with the same concept. So that goes with KB into W2 into 1000 divided by delta TB. See, M2 you are taking here, delta TB will come here. Delta TB into W1. You can use this formula and you can calculate the molar mass of the solute also. Okay, so now we will just go with the problem. So we will go through with the problem. The boiling point of benzene is 353.23. First we write what is given. Okay. So what is given over here? The boiling point of benzene. So benzene boiling point they have given, that is TT0 as 353.23 Kelvin. Okay. Now when 1.80 gram of non-volatile solute is dissolved, in a sense solute, 1.80 is nothing but it is a solute. Solute in the sense that is W2, because W2, M2, it goes with the solute, right? Second phase which will be considered for solute. So W2 is for solute, so that is 1.80 gram of non-volatile solute was dissolved in 90 gram of benzene, that is W1 is 90 gram. The boiling point is raised. After adding solute to solvent, boiling point is raised. Now in the sense it is there in the form of solution. So now if it is there in the form of solution, then we can write it as TB as 354.11 K. Calculate the molar mass of the solute. KB for benzene, that is your ebullioscopic constant they have given as 2.53. In the sense KB as 2.53 Kelvin kilojoule per mole. Now according to the formula, so which formula you are supposed to use to calculate the molar mass? Molar mass you have to find it out. Molar mass of the solute, in the sense MV, you need to find out. So formula it comes as MV or M2 anyways. Okay. So it is equal to KB into W2 into 1000 divided by, instead of MV, delta TB will come into W1. But here say KB is given, W W1 is a delta Kb they did not give. Okay, elevation in boiling point they have not given, but they have given whether pure solvent as well as solution. What is the boiling point they have given? By using all that we can find out what is delta Kb. So now what is delta Kb? Delta Kb formula, it goes like delta Kb is equal to Tb minus Tb naught, right? So what is Tb over here? Tb is 354.11 minus Tb naught is 353.23 is equal to, you will get 0.88 Kelvin. Okay, so delta Tb is 0.88 Kelvin. So that you have to substitute over here. So it comes as M2 is equal to Kb is 2.53 into W2 is 1.80 into 1000 divided by delta Tb is 0.88 into W1 is 90. So whatever answer you will get, see M2 57.5 you will get, almost around this you will get. So write in terms of gram per mole. So molar mass should be written in terms of gram per mole. So this is regarding the problem. Okay. So this is the way to solve. Okay. So what you are supposed to do while solving is very easy. Substitution is also very easy. But while writing, given whatever you will write, that should be proper. W2, W1, you should not get confused. Okay. As well as Tb, Tb0 also, you should not get confused. So after writing, direct substitution so that you get answer. And unit is very important over here. For unit also, you will be having marks. Okay. So this is regarding elevation in boiling point. So the next colligative property, so that will be considered as depression in freezing point. Okay, so third colligative property will be known as depression, in a sense decreasing in the freezing point. That you know why it is, it goes to the depression, because the temperature when you go with the freezing point, it should be less, it should decrease, right? So that we are saying, taking as depression in freezing point. So now what is meaning by freezing point? So freezing point is nothing but it is a temperature where when you go with a particular substance, okay, so the vapor pressure of that liquid as well as in the same substance, okay, vapor pressure of in the solid state, okay, so it will be equal. In simple way, if I tell, freezing point is nothing but the temperature in which your liquid as well as solid both will coexist. So in this temperature, your liquid phase as well as solid phase both will coexist. So then it will be considered as freezing point. So it is a certain vapor pressure. Okay, in the certain temperature, the vapor phase of liquid phase as well as solid phase, it will be same. Okay, vapor phase of solid as well as liquid phase, it will be same. So if we can say this as liquid as well as solid, it will coexist at a particular temperature. So that also we can call it as freezing point. For example, when you go with the water, okay, we can say the water freezing point is 0 degrees Celsius. Why it is so? Because in this temperature, the vapor phase of your water, okay, as well as the solidification will take place, right? So the solid vapor phase of vapor pressure, it will be equal, okay, it will be same. So that will be considered as your freezing point. So in this temperature we can say here in your water, it is, liquid form also will exist as well as solid form also will exist with this temperature. So that will be considered as freezing point. So now we will go with the earth concept. It is nothing but the vapor pressure of your pure solvent, so that will be more. When you will add solute to it, it will be, it is decreasing, okay. In the sense when it is there with the solution form, it will decrease. So now if you draw a graph, so vapor pressure versus temperature. So in this graph what we can observe, we deal with the freezing point. Okay. So now you are taking pure solvent, just take a pure solvent. So when you go with the freezing point of that pure solvent, it comes like this. See, it will be seen like this. Okay. In this manner, goes like this. Okay. What is this two curve representing? If you are taking any of the liquid, okay, pure solvent, right? So it is, if it is ever the liquid form, so this is a liquid medium. Okay. So from this is a freezing point. After this, the solid will appear. For example, you take water itself. Okay. Water, liquid. Liquid form you just take. So for certain temperature. Okay. So for certain temperature, it will be there with the liquid form. And a particular temperature where it started freezing. Okay. So where it started freezing. So we can denote this as TF naught. Okay, because we are going with pure solid. So we can represent it as TF, freezing point of pure solvent. Okay. So this is the freezing point. After that, what will happen? Solidification will take place. So this is nothing but your solid form of your pure solvent. Now when you go there, in the sense for the pure solvent, just add any non-volatile solute. Okay. So when you add non-volatile solute, what will happen? The vapor pressure will decrease. Okay. Now we are supposed to go with the lesser vapor pressure. So now here what will happen? The vapor pressure will decrease as well as if you go with the temperature. Okay, as temperature decreases, the vapor pressure can be seen. Now we will go with the solution form. From here to here, it will be there with the liquid. And after this, see, this is the point, freezing point. Okay, so this is the freezing point. So what I can take it as TF, okay, freezing point of solution. After that, it will be there with the same solid form. Okay, it will continue the solid form. So this is the freezing point of your solution, and this is the freezing point of pure solvent. So when we compare, the freezing point of solution will be lesser than the pure solvent. So whatever the difference will be there, so that difference we are going to say as delta TF. So what is delta TF? So delta TF is nothing but this minus this. Okay. So freezing point of pure solvent minus freezing point of solution. So that will be considered as delta TF minus TF naught. Delta TF is equal to TF naught minus TF. Okay. So that goes with your elevation and boiling point. So this graph is important. I guess you understood. So this goes for pure solvent and this goes for solution, where from liquid, okay, when you add a non-volatile solute, by that the vapor pressure decreases. So from here to here it will be there with the liquid form, and this is the freezing point. After that it will be there with the solid form itself. So freezing point of solution will be lesser, okay, when you go with the temperature. This will be lesser when you compare with the pure solvent. For this, see, as I said, delta TF is equal to TF naught minus of TF. Now if I am writing in terms of molarity, okay, so those are related to molarity. So we can write delta TF is directly proportional to molarity. So same thing, so as you have written for boiling point, so delta TF is equal to KF into M. So what is KF? KF is nothing but freezing point, okay, depression constant, or you can say molar depression constant, or you can say cryoscopic constant. Anyone? Okay, so this differs for different kind of solvent. Okay, so mainly this goes with the nature of the solvent, not with the the particles. Okay, so delta TF is equal to KF into M. So delta TF is equal to KF into, what is mean by molarity? The same thing, it goes W2 by M2 into 1000 into W1. So this is the formula that you are supposed to use to check with the freezing point. As well as if you want to find out the molar mass, the formula comes as KF into W2 into 1000 divided by delta TF into W1. So this is the formula you are supposed to use to calculate the depression in freezing point. So now, to find out the value of KF and KB, for state students, they will give the value of KF and KB, they will give when you will go with the problem. Sometimes for CBSE, they won't give the value of KF as well as KB. Okay? So you are supposed supposed to find out other all the concepts forms we will give. Okay, what is the value? So now as I said, Tx is nothing but which goes with the depression in freezing point. This is a constant form. Okay, which will be known as cryoscopic constant, and this is known as hygroscopic constant. So this value directly it depends on the nature of the solvent. So now when you are finding for freezing point, by that the formula it goes like R into mi into Tf naught square divided by 1000 into delta H of fusion. Okay, so R is nothing but, in both the cases R is nothing but your gas constant. M1 in both the cases it is nothing but molar mass of the first, in the sense it goes with your solvent. Okay, molar mass of solvent, and here because you are finding Kf for freezing point, so it goes with the freezing point of pure solvent. Okay, square of it you are supposed to do, divided by 1000 into delta H of fusion. So change in enthalpy, whatever it will take, that you are supposed to write over here to find out Kf value. In the same way, hygroscopic constant, when you are finding R is gas constant, this is molar mass of your solvent, and this is body part of your pure solvent. So means where you have to do, divided by 1000 into delta H of vaporization. So here boiling in the sense vaporization will take place, so that delta H change in enthalpy you are supposed to substitute over here. So that will be considered as Kf and Kb. Okay, so next we will go for problem under this concept. So now 45 gram of ethylene glycol is mixed with 600 gram of water. Calculate the freezing point of depression you need to find out, as well as freezing point of solution. Okay, freezing point of solution in the sense Tf you have to find out, as well as delta T, freezing point of depression also you have to find out. So what is given in the question? So given you are supposed to write, say 45 gram of ethylene glycol is mixed, in the sense you are going to mix a solute, so that is W2 is equal to 45 gram. Okay, and it is mixed with 600 gram of water, that is nothing but W1 is 600 gram of water. Calculate the freezing point as well as freezing point of solution. K value they have given as 1.86 Kelvin kilojoule per mole. So first we need to find out what is the freezing point of depression. So formula comes as delta Tf is equal to Kf into W2 into 1000 divided by M2 into W1. Direct you can substitute and you can find the answer. Okay, so Kf is nothing but 1.86 into W2 is 45 into 1000 divided by M2. M2 is nothing but molar mass of the solute. Solute is nothing but ethylene glycol, right? So find out molar mass of ethylene glycol. Carbon 2 and N2 plus hydrogen 1 into 6, oxygen 16 into 2. So total it comes as 62 into W1 is 600. Okay, so just find out whatever answer you will get. So delta Tf is equal to, you will get the answer with 2.24. Okay, 2.24 or 2.5 you may get. So just substitute and find the answer. Delta Tf in terms of Kelvin you need to find. Okay, so next what they have given, you are supposed to find out freezing point of solution, you have to find it out. So how to find out? See, by using of this formula. Okay, so delta Tf is equal to Tf naught minus of Tf. So what is the value of delta Tf? That is 2.25 Kelvin. Okay, is equal to Tf naught. Tf naught is nothing but you are going to be within the freezing point of your solvent. So freezing point generally of water, freezing point of solvent in the sense that is water, right? What is the freezing point of water? That is 0 degree Celsius. So when you go with the Kelvin, that comes with 273.15 minus of Tf. You need to find out Tf. Okay, so just you can take this to this side, find the value of Tf. So Tf you may get around 270.9 Kelvin. So this is a way of finding with the answers. Okay, so now here you are supposed to find out with the freezing point of depression as well as freezing point of solution. So under these two concepts, any problems are, other problems are there in go through it, find the answer. If you have any doubt, then the class will start by then.